Are the Israelis, I mean, clearly understand the danger of a UN resolution?
Yes.
So what's necessary to get the parties back to the table? What do they have to do? What risk do they have to take? What do the Palestinians have to do? And what risk do they have to take?
Well, both sides have to accept the president's statement as the basis for getting into the negotiations. That would be very difficult for both of them. The Palestinians...
And not much time.
Not much time, a matter of a few months.
And in the summer.
As the president said, the Palestinians walked away from the last talks because their demands were not met. Their demand for an extension of the moratorium on new housing construction in the settlements that had been in place for 10 months was not extended as they requested, so they left the talks. We did have talks, four meetings between Prime Minister Netanyahu and President Abbas, but they didn't make much progress. The time was short, and they didn't continue. What the Palestinians have to do is to come back to the talks. That's the way to get this process going, to get into negotiations, to try to reach agreement and to thrash out the differences between them.
So what do you make of the Prime Minister's argument about the Hamas-Fatah agreement?
Well, that's a very serious matter. I think the Prime Minister is correct that it's very difficult for Israel to negotiate with a party that is committed to Israel's destruction and doesn't observe what we regard as democratic principles. However, what President Abbas has for many years stood for nonviolence and negotiation as the way to achieve the proper result. He's the person that Israel and the United States and others should be empowering to try to get him back into the talks on a basis that will permit an agreement to be reached. And under we don't know how this Hamas-Fatah thing is going to develop. He says that
he's being Abbas.
Abbas, yeah, is going to organize it in a way that the purpose of it is to hold an election. So we say we're for democracy. Israel says they're for democracy. We should not be discouraging the holding of an election. We think an election should be held. And obviously, we hope that Abbas and the Fatah party will win the election, not Hamas.
Join us online at charlierose.com.